Right, so I just finished Gemini, and this reading is, I think this is going to be my last one today. Okay, so we're on Cancer, right? Okay. I'm just nosy about my person. I love them, but I don't want to admit that I do reading. Okay, so let's see what comes up. Okay, why don't you want to admit that you love them? What is that about? Let's check into that. What sign are we on? Cancer. Okay. Okay. So it's like money matters affecting the relationship. Okay. Money matters. Okay, which is really strange because I'm getting like a influx of money here. So that means like it's like tons of money. I don't know what the problem is. Okay, let me see. Yeah. So whatever this story is, and if this doesn't resonate, it's not your story. Okay, so but what I'm getting is the reason why you're not together is because there was some money, people may not agree on money things. Now, sometimes it's within a family dynamic that causes that. Sometimes it's work problems, right, around money. Sometimes just lack of money can cause all these imbalances. Okay. All right, yeah. I can't, I mean, it just keeps repeating, right? Ace of Pentacles reverse. Yeah. Oh my gosh. Okay, so it's like you walked away from each other. Okay, so now let's talk about this. This could be any sign that was harnessing the Aquarius energy. Okay, but it could be Aquarius or Pisces, because sometimes, a lot of times when I do readings, a Pisces is carrying that Aquarius energy, could have like put their foot down for some reason or another. Okay. And due to money issues. Okay, now that could be all kinds of things. Some people could have a habit of spending money in places that the partner doesn't agree on, right? Okay, now, Ten of Pentacles, or it could even be just two different kinds of spending style, like habits here. I'm getting like one person likes to save and invest in other things, and then the one likes to just spend it. Okay. All right, so Ten of Pentacles reverse, and that felt destabilizing. Okay. Even though they're sexy and passionate. Okay. Huh. Okay, but there's gonna be like, it's like victories along the way. That's what I'm getting with your person. Victories along the way. Yeah, I feel like the problem was, is this cool, see, this one's reversed. It's like closed off energy, which what we need is this open-hearted communication. And that will bring in the new beginning, and I feel like they're keeping an eye on you, or vice versa. Okay, that was coming up in, what was that? Taurus was, you might, for some of you, might be dealing with Scorpio or Taurus. That was coming up there. All right, now, King of Wands, that's reversed. Okay, so I feel like that's you. You had all you can handle in different directions, and, and you've thought decisively many times about who you wanted to go towards, but I feel like this is many different people, is what I'm getting. All right, let's see. Okay, and that's the energy is what caused people not wanting to work on it with you and closed off their new beginning with you. Even though they were attracted to you, Prince of Wands, and they saw you as kind of, not always honest, hiding stuff. Well, you could have just been hiding stuff, and then they, they saw it as something other than that, though. All right, so it could be a Virgo or a Pisces. How you would recognize is that they go to their own beat of their own drum, and this was coming up as a musician card the other day, so it could be a musician for some of you. And they're just, oh, so they could be in their Piscean energy. And they lounge around a lot because, especially, I feel like with this Neptune retrograde business. So that means they've been laying around a lot thinking about you. Okay, and sometimes they think about you in a positive way and sometimes not. They didn't always have the confidence to go towards you or call you or connect to you, even though they wanted to. So they let go. And it felt heavy to them to do that. But they saw you as not wanting to give to it. For some of you, that's a water sign. This card to me looks like an emperor card. So sometimes an emperor, right? That's not. What is that? That's like, okay, so an emperor, sometimes it's like we only allow my way, right? We only allow my way and no other ways. Okay. And so they could have seen you then sometimes as maybe generous and then not so generous. Okay. They could have felt like there were strings attached to, let's say you called. And you wanted some sort of physical connection. They could have, if you gave them a gift or something, they could have felt like there was some sort of strings attached. Okay. But now I feel like you're in a different place than you were back then. That's what I'm getting. You're in a totally different place than you were back then. And you're like born again, this new person. And you want to be. A positive partner. Okay. A positive partner. Okay. Now, for some of you, you love them, but you don't really want to keep working on it with them. Really? Okay. All right. So I beg to differ. You do. Okay. And this Three of Pentacles reversed is I'm getting for some of you, it took like going to different places to figure out you really do want to be with this one. Okay. The attraction's there, that's for sure. Ace of Wands. Okay, and Eight of Wands. Man, this card's been coming out a lot. Okay, now Taurus got that in the first card out in one reading that I did. So this is like fast physical movement too. They might move fast. This could be you. But this is a progress card too. So also here's a lion, right? So it could be like now you feel like you could have raised your self-esteem and worth through this experience. And you feel more confident than you have been in the past. Okay, so you want to send that Cupid's arrow quickly. Okay. But this is like feeling excitement again towards love. So you could have taken a pause there, and it doesn't matter whether you, I feel like you really love this person, whether you want to be with them or not. But now it's like, You've had that journey and you can go in a new direction or continue with them. And I feel like you would have positive results here. Okay. All right, so what's this? Yeah, see, this is like this is my resistance card. And this is like rising above, standing firm on. This could also be like setting healthy boundaries. Okay. You know, when two people come together, they like feel out their comfort zones, right? And what they're okay with and what they're not okay with. And so I feel like no matter what has transpired, you were able to rise above all that. And for some of you, that's just your own resistance to the connection. And you're going to swiftly move towards them at some point. Okay, now here's Seven of Cups. I feel like on both sides, you both have a lot of potentials out there. Okay. And that could have been the problem here with this Three of Pentacles reverse back here for some of you. You didn't want manyness. You just wanted to be one-on-one with them. Okay, or vice versa. All right. But I also am getting in this card, it's like when you're with them, you feel like it's a spa day. That's nice. I like that. Okay. And what is this? Oh, okay. So, see, this is saying, do you really believe that you can have it all? Because I feel like this is already, the dream work's already been created here. Okay. Oh, I see what this is saying. Okay. So, it's like you get in this dreamy space, right? And then you're like, oh, I want to call this person, right? And you swiftly contact them, right? And maybe you meet resistance. And maybe they say yes and maybe they say no. But the key is not to let that, if you keep getting impulses to go back, keep trying. That's what I'm getting, okay, with that one. Even if you fear, this is subconscious, you fear in the background that every time you contact them that you're going to be met with this. The Queen of Swords, which is cold and calculated and not really interested, and all these other things. Okay, but if you envision this, every time you get the impulse and feeling and passion, and just do that, I feel like you'll have spa day with them. Okay, moon reverse and moon. Okay, for some of you, it's an earth or water sign. Let's get a moon card and then we'll close out. Okay. Yeah. I feel like there are times that you felt defeated, that they just wanted to be alone and independent. And I feel like that's where the misunderstanding was for some people. I felt like the feeling here that I'm getting is that you are perhaps mistaking their fierce independence for wanting to be alone, and that's just not true. That's what I'm getting. Okay. All right. So let's see what the moon card says. Okay. So reflect on your priorities. Right, here's that Aquarius energy. So they could have been mirroring some a little bit of you. And this to me, it's like, is this a child, right? Okay, so I feel like you could birth something, but it also looks like a statue. So you could have felt like you were like that reading that I did the other day, Romancing the Stone, like they were hard to budge. Okay. All right, and then break through the tension, right? So you want spa day with your person, right? That feel good place. And this was a problem for that King of Wands energy. It was like, and I felt like that was whoever the Emperor was. And it was, Emperor or the King of Wands energy. It was like, but not so positive, was causing this control issues. All right, so see, here's the Virgo energy. Take inspired action. It's like, keep moving when you get the inspiration to, and maybe not let your intellect break it down. Okay, so I feel like you're reaching for the bigger picture here. Okay, and yeah, relax. New moon in Cancer. Okay. All right, that's what I'm getting. Oh, look at this. Focus on the positive. Okay. And I feel like that brings the outcome that you want in that Ten of Cups. I leave you with that.